5, 3, 2, 1.
This is your Channel 18 News.
For Thursday, January 31st, 2002.
Let's go to NBC's Chief Foreign Affairs Correspondent, who is in Washington with the latest on kidnapped reporter Danielle Pearl.
Wall Street Journal reporter Danielle Pearl is under a death threat from those kidnappers in Pakistan who say that they will execute him before nightfall unless they get their demands.
New emailed pictures and this threatening misspelled note, saying, quote, "We will execute him within 24 hours unless America fulfills our demands." The note from an unidentified terror group wanting F-16 fighter jets for Pakistan and better treatment for Pakistani prisoners at Guantanamo base. A nightmare for Pearl's wife, expecting their first child in May.
I am pregnant, I'm going to have a baby, and we are trying at our level to create a better world. What can I do? Nobody has contacted me. Nobody is trying to, you know, to tell me what I should do.
Pearl abducted in Karachi a week ago on his way to an interview for a story on accused shoe bomber Richard Reed, apparently lured by an elaborate trap of fake emails and calls.
She said I had an appointment somewhere close by, and while he was sitting with me, a phone call came in which he confirmed that he'd be arriving. He's very close by.
The FBI is in Pakistan.
I think what we're dealing with here is a terrorist group with clear political objectives. This is not a terrorist group of the Al-Qaeda variety, which is driven by a sort of fanatical Islamic fundamentalism.
And now the State Department is warning Americans in Pakistan to be careful because Pearl's kidnappers are also threatening to target other American journalists.
We're obviously very concerned about the threat.
The terror group first accused Pearl of being a CIA agent, which the CIA and Pearl's newspaper strongly deny. Israel says it's absolutely
Good morning,
false.
Valley View High School.
The majority of the state senates you put novice voted against the constituents.
Good
it's
morning, Valley View
how
High School.
Times
I'm Eric Madsen.
Can run
I'm
for
Sean
office
Hancock.
Yesterday.
This is your Channel
Voters
18 News
votes
for January
as many times as they want.
2000.
The Senate voted 27-8 in favor of the measures that would go away with term limits. It took them about an hour to decide. Lawmakers say that this limit is an issue they will have to face again.
The question this fall will not be on term limits. The question will be, did the legislature listen to the voters?
Senator Sandy, who you just saw there, voted against the repeal. Now the issue goes to the governor's desk, and he has 5 days to review, excluding Sunday. He has said that he will veto the bill.
Seniors, the scholarship boards found in the government classrooms have been updated and have many good scholarships that apply to everyone.
The office will not be accepting any Valentine deliveries. Birthday deliveries can still be sent.
We got a new reporter today, and his name's Mike. So how's the weather today, Mike?
It was cold a few days ago, but it's going to start warming up throughout the week. As you can see today, it was really cloudy outside. And for the current temps today, Boise was at 23, Nampa was at 23, and Caldwell at 24. Around the state, it was 34 degrees in Coeur d'Alene and 29 in Lewiston, 23 here in Boise, which has gone up a lot more. And Idaho Falls was down at zero, which is cold. And for your satellite map, it cleared up this morning, but for the rest of the day, it's going to start getting more cloudier, and all this precipitation up here will cause us to have a little bit of snow showers going into tomorrow. At 7 a.m. this morning, it was 24 degrees. At noon, it was 28. And towards 5 a.m., it'll be 31 degrees, which was a lot better than we've had for a couple days. And for your five-day forecast, Friday for a high of 33 and for a low of 25, Saturday at 37 and a low of 24, Sunday at a high of 38 and a low of 26, Monday a high of 40 and a low of 26, and Tuesday a high of 41 and a low of 28. Looks like it's going to start warming up into the weekend.
I'm glad.
The Valley View High School Drafting Club is having a fundraiser. They're collecting empty printer cartridges of all size, shapes, and colors to take to the recyclers.
Please bring all of your empty cartridges to room 119 and put them in the box labeled printer cartridges. For more information, come to a drafting club meeting Friday, February 1st, right after school in room 119.
Now let's go to sports with Melissa.
Thanks, Heather. Congratulations to the girls' junior varsity basketball team for winning the SIC 4A championship last night. The game was played last night at Emmett, beating Nampa's JV team 29-27 with an excellent buzzer shot from Christy Markeen. Way to get it done, girls, last night and throughout the regular season. Good job. Last night marked another display of the talent of our wrestling team, as our Falcons squad took a decisive 42-18 victory in Nampa against Nampa High. Our boys were led by Dallas Stinger, 112, with a 5-3 upset, Creed Knee, 130 pounds, with an 8-7 decision, Dan Perkins, 135, Nick McKellop, 140, and Joe Gasolacuto, 152, won by decisions. David Thomas, at 189, won by technical fall. Hayden Plocker at 160 had a major decision, and Kyle Cheney at 145, Kip Watson 103, Alex Holtry and 171 recorded pins. Also scoring points last night were Nate Freeman 130, Caleb Christensen 135, Mark Atkinson 140, Tyler Hinman 160, and DJ Crisp 171. Next up for the boys is the Weezer Invitational on Friday and Saturday. Good luck, guys. Also in Valley View Sports, our Lady Falcons basketball team heads out to Emmett High tonight for the start of the District 3 and 4A tournament, while our boys head out to Caldwell High tomorrow night for a showdown. Make the trip and support both our proud basketball teams. Let's go back to the desk.
Good morning, Valley View. I'm Kyle Sabins.
And I'm Crystal McCracken.
And this is your Channel 18
Give the gift of music to your special someone this
for
Valentine's
January 31st,
Day. Make this your special by ordering a singing Valentine sung by Treasure Valley's elite group, the Valley View High School Choral Edition. The cost is $8 at any of the Valley View School, $10 elsewhere in the Nampa or Caldwell.
All Valentines come with a box of sweethearts, but to give a little touch of romance, add a carnation for only $2. Call Mr. Curtis at 454-9253 for information. They will be singing When I'm 64 and Once Upon a Dream. They will not be going to the Boise area. They're sorry for the inconvenience.
There will be a VICA meeting today after school, Thursday, in room 125.
Students attending the Caldwell Valley View boys basketball game Friday night, we are asked to bring a cold cereal to donate to the Salvation Army Food Bank. The donation does not replace the cost of admission.
Anyone interested in being a part of the Valley View mock trial teams needs to meet in Mrs. Funderburg's room Saturday, February 9th at 8 o'clock a.m. There are a limited number of positions. Your attendance is imperative.
There will be a meeting Friday, February 1st during period 3 for all of those students in 11th and 12th grade who are interested in attending the Hispanic Youth Symposium in Sun Valley in April. Ms. Allen is present. Then we'll present the information in the student council room 116. Please see Ms. Allen in room 205 for a pass.
That's all for your Channel 18 News.
Let's see what's for today's lunch.
Joe, I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? Cotton Eye Joe. Fit out and been for Cotton Eye Joe.